There's new models coming out almost every week. So why should you care about Azure OpenAI Services' new O1 series of models? Well, these models are an entirely new class of models that represent a shift from quick, intuitive thinking to slower, more deliberate reasoning. We're going to talk about how O1 works and the three key signs of a strong reasoning use case. As an analogy, let's take two people, Dominic and Jen. Now, when you ask Dominic a question, he gives you a quick and intelligent answer. However, Dominic might not spend as much time thinking through the problem. This is a little bit like current foundation models. So, for example, GPT-4o, it gives you a really quick answer and it's very good, but it doesn't spend that much time thinking through all the dimensions of the problem. Now let's look at Jen. So when you ask Jen a question, she gives you a slow, deliberate response. So she spends more time thinking through the problem. This is quite like how O1 works, going over it and attacking it from different angles before giving you a response. So for complex problems, O1 is really great. And these are both great models, and it's about picking the right tool for the right job. But how do you know when to use one model over the other? Well, what we're going to talk about are the three signs of a strong reasoning use case. The first sign is something that involves multiple data sets. The second is it involves multi-step reasoning. And the last one is the problem should be sufficiently complex or involve an open-ended problem. To bring this to life, we're going to run through a fictional example of a company called Contoso, who's looking to expand their skincare range from the UK into either Australia, Canada, or New Zealand. They need help making the right decision, and we're going to use O1 to help them do that. Let's see how it works. One of the cool features about O1 is that you can set the reasoning effort, which is how long the model spends thinking about the problem. In this case, we're going to use medium because the problem is not too hard or too simple. Now, I mentioned the first signal of a strong O1 reasoning use case is it involves multiple data sets. And in this example, we have many structured data sets. That includes things like tables of manufacturing costs and line graphs projecting sales. The magic happens when we bring unstructured data into it, because we've had algorithms that can analyze structured data for a long time, but we need people and their reasoning capability in order to use their general knowledge and pick out clues in that unstructured data. And the O1 model, when we look at things like subject matter expert reports and emails, it's able to combine all these data sets and then reason over them to arrive at a conclusion. The second sign is when we have multi-step reasoning. So let's see O1 generate the response to this problem. And while it's doing this, you can see some of those key features we all know and love. Things like function calling, where if it needs additional data, it can go off and retrieve that data. Or if it needs to take action, it can actually do that in agentic use cases. Okay, so now that we've got the response, you can see that O1 has had to reason over the problem. It had to first explore different data sets. It had to come up with a strategy for solving the problem. It had to calculate the costs. It had to calculate the margin. It had to compare the different countries to each other before arriving at a set of recommendations. So O1 does a fantastic job running through these different reasoning steps. And the third sign of a good use case is that it's sufficiently complex or involves open-ended problems. For simpler problems, any model will do a pretty good job. But for a more complex problem, you could use a normal LLM, but it's a little bit like using a junior employee for a task. They'll get the job done, but you might need to step them through each step of the process. Using O1 is a little bit like working with someone who's more experienced. You can give them a task and they'll work out the right way to get to the answer. And you can see in this problem, it's pretty open-ended. There's a lot of data and there's a few valid ways to get to the answer. And O1 was able to successfully find that. So bringing it all together in this use case, how did we go? GPT-4o did a good job, but unfortunately it got a little bit confused about the cost data and actually arrived at the wrong conclusion that Australia is the best market to go into. Whereas O1 which had longer to think through the problem, because there's almost 45 pages of data that it has. It analyzed that the manufacturing costs in Canada made the UK company much more competitive, so it gave the correct recommendation. Now, this was a fairly generic example, but we've actually built industry-specific examples that accompany this one, so I'd encourage you to check those out. We're excited to see what you develop using the Azure OpenAI service and the O1 series of models. Head on over to our homepage to get started today.